Regular exercise has many benefits. It can reduce the risks of developing illnesses such as heart disease, stroke, type 2 diabetes, and even cancer by up to 50%. It can reduce the risk of early death by up to 30%, and it is considered by many to be therapeutic as well as a great technique for mental strengthening. Whatever your reason for exercising, it reaps many benefits. However, when thinking of exercising, one thing that comes to many people's mind is either jogging or hitting the treadmill. With a rise in the popularity of high-intensity exercising, this video will compare the effects of jogging and sprinting and decide which exercise is ultimately the best. So let's cover the basics first. Jogging is an aerobic exercise that relies on oxygen and involves running at a slow pace for a long time. Sprinting involves running as fast as you can over a limited period of time or distance. It is an anaerobic exercise that initially relies on oxygen, but once the body's oxygen levels aren't available at a fast enough rate for the body's demand, it switches to anaerobic mode and burns fat and glycogen for energy. Sprinting is therefore classified as a high-intensity interval exercise. So the first category to compare jogging and sprinting is fat loss, since that is one of the most common reasons people start exercising. As mentioned, jogging is an aerobic exercise and relies primarily on oxygen for energy without needing to extract extra energy from the body. Sprinting can't rely on oxygen and therefore burns fat for energy. As a result, sprinting burns more fat than jogging. Moreover, sprinting has been found to increase your basal metabolic rate throughout the rest of the day more than jogging. Your basal metabolic rate is the amount of energy you need for your body to function while at rest. This means that sprinting continues to burn fat in your body even while resting. In fact, a study in 1994 found that men and women who took part in a 15-week high-intensity program lost more fat than those who took part in a 20-week endurance program. A typical sprint session consists of 30 seconds of an all-out sprint followed by 4 minutes of recovery, and this is repeated 4 to 6 times. This means that one sprint session consists of only 3 to 4 minutes of exercise, which means that sprinting burns more fat and requires less time to do it than jogging. The second category is muscle growth. You only need to see the difference between a marathon runner and a sprinter to know the answer to this. Although both exercises involve the same muscle groups, sprinting causes the leg muscles to contract more rapidly than jogging, causing more muscle tears and therefore activating the body's muscle building system to build more muscle. Moreover, sprinting causes the body to release more human growth hormone, which is a muscle building and fat burning hormone. So sprinting easily wins this category. A common reason why people exercise is due to its therapeutic qualities, and so the last category is happiness and stress. A 2017 study by the University of Turku found that high-intensity exercises release more endorphins than a one-hour jog. Endorphins are hormones in our body that elevate mood and give a sense of relaxation, and sprinting releases more of it. Another study conducted in 2014 found that participants who took part in high-intensity exercises enjoyed the exercises more and were more likely to continue it than those who took part in endurance training. Lastly, as mentioned, sprinting releases more growth hormone and testosterone, and these hormones reduce the level of cortisol in the body. Cortisol has been associated to stress by many studies, and so sprinting reduces its levels. So to sum up, people who sprint produce more happy hormones, produce less stress hormones, and are more likely to carry on exercising in the long term. There are many factors to consider when choosing whether to sprint or jog, but according to the three factors discussed in this video, sprinting is the clear winner. That being said, sprinting puts more pressure on the body and the joints, and overdoing it can increase the likelihood of injury over the long term. Moreover, due to how intense it is, it should be avoided by people with existing heart conditions, high blood pressure, or respiratory problems, as it can cause further damage. At the end of the day, choosing whether to sprint or jog is down to personal goals, abilities, and interest. Both are excellent forms of exercise, and regardless of which one you choose to do, you can still enjoy the many benefits of exercising. If you have enjoyed this video, please subscribe to the channel and check out the other videos.